to childhood snacks, who doesn't love that classic cereal aisle favorite? The toaster pastry. You know what I'm talking about. You pop them in the toaster, they come up, and they're so warm and delicious. Well, joining us today with her own take on this tasty treat is our friend Kristina Kuzmic. Welcome back, Kristina.
Thank you. I'm so excited to be here.
And by the way, these, the ones that Kristina's making for us today, are way better than the ones in the store because you know exactly what's going in them.
Yes, butter. Butter and sugar.
But also ingredients you can pronounce. These are all things you have in your pantry.
Yes, no chemicals. So we have flour and butter here, and we're gonna cut it. Have you ever heard of that? You know,
you got
a cookbook. Yeah. You gotta cut the butter in, meaning you're gonna incorporate it all, and you're gonna make a mess, and that's good.
It doesn't taste
that's good, because nothing in life should be perfect.
And I know this is really nostalgic for you as well, because you're from Croatia, but when you came here, you had one of these for the first time at a friend's house, and you're like, what is this amazing thing I'm eating?
So my grandmother taught me in Croatia to cook from scratch. So I was like, wait, soup comes in cans? Like, what? And then I was sleeping over at a friend's house, and she pulled out this cellophane-y thing and opened it up and threw something in a toaster, and breakfast was served. So I was like, these Americans are crazy. So I decided to try and make it from scratch.
And by the way, you've done a fantastic job, and your grandma would be proud. I know she'd
I think she would. So sugar, salt, then you add some ice water. You need to make sure it's ice so the butter stays kind of chunky. Oh, that gives you those fatty pockets that you want.
Yeah.
Fat is good, people. Okay, and then you're going to mix it all up, but we're going to swap out.
And if you don't have this guy, this fancy guy,
just use two knives.
Two knives.
Get dirty. Use your hands. By the way, cook with your family. Will cooking with your kids make for a greater mess? Yes, but it'll also make for a greater human.
Oh, it's the best thing in the world.
Yes.
That's the best thing in the world.
All right, so now
then you're going to roll it. You're going to chill it. You're going to roll it out.
And make it really thin like this.
Yes, and then you're basically just going to cut it into rectangles. I don't know my shapes anymore. I'm exhausted. And then you're going to brush it with some egg wash. We're just painting.
This looks so easy.
This looks easy.
And by the way, listen, people always feel like they have to make everything perfect, blah, blah, blah. If you don't have time for this, buy pie dough, and you can still make it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Exactly right.
Get an extra hour of sleep. Why not? Okay, we're going to make the filling.
Okay.
We got brown sugar.
Simple.
Some flour. Cinnamon.
Oof, that looks good.
Vanilla extract.
Just wait to eat it. It's delicious.
Mix that up.
I could eat just that.
And you'll feel good about serving this to your family.
Would you like a bite?
Yeah.
You know, you'll feel better about it than the ones that, you know, you
come with. My family wouldn't get any.
You can't pronounce half that stuff.
And by the way,
know where it comes from, it's not good.
I know. And by the way, people are so anti-carbs these days. I feel like if you do squats while you're making carbs, join me here.
Yes.
There you go. Okay. So you're going to put some filling in. Okay. You don't want to go all the way to the edges.
So
you don't want to overfill them. That's sort of my go-to move.
Okay. Oh, this is my favorite part.
Now, do you egg wash the outsides or just the insides?
We're going to do the outside,
too. Okay, I just was curious.
So crimp them. See, they already look cute.
It's so beautiful and rustic. It's like you own your own bakery.
I know. This is something your kids can help with.
All right.
And then you brush
it. It looks much fancier than just you did that with a fork.
Right? Mm-hmm. And you can change the filling depending on what you
want. You can put anything in there.
Strawberry jam.
You could put kale if you're one of those types of people. I'm not.
Put some bone broth in there, camera.
Sure. Right. Sure.
So then you're going to bake those 375 for 15 minutes.
Okay.
Because you guys are like magic here. Oh my gosh.
Okay, you pull those out. I'll move
this. I'm ready to eat.
There you go.
Look at that.
I mean, come on.
Yes,
very nice.
And then all you have to do is make some icing out of
powdered sugar.
See, thank you.
Milk, cinnamon. And I think we put vanilla extract.
We did put vanilla.
So it's actually healthy. It's got cinnamon in there.
That's true.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh my
I got to talk to you about your new book. Hold on, but don't hold still. This is so great.
And it's got so much wisdom
in it. Tell us a little bit about it.
Sure. And I just found out that it's a bestseller on the Publishers Weekly bestseller.
Gosh, that's amazing.
You know what? I went from being divorced and broke and sleeping on a floor, sharing a small bedroom with my kids, and just feeling completely worthless. And so this book is my stories of how I went from hating myself, hating my life, to where I am now. And there's nothing more special about me than anybody else. So it's sort of a book for anybody who has ever struggled. If things happen in your life that you didn't expect, which is true for all of us.
Yes.
I hope this book will bring a lot of hope and some humor.
It will. Because maybe the circumstances are different with different people's struggles, but the essence of it is the same, and good for you to put
we
it out
all
there.
All struggle.
So many people.
Yes, and I'm on a national tour.
Are you?
It's a lot of comedy and validation.
She might be coming to a city near you. Check that out.
Why don't we do it?
Well, in they're waiting
for theirs. I'm not it, please.
I can't
you
wait.
Wait, I understand you inspire a lot of people to be their authentic self as well, and you were inspired yourself by none other than Oprah. Tell us about that.
Speaking of being authentic, I'm talking with my mouth full.
Please, I waited for you to take a bite before.
I know, you're so kind.
Yeah.
There's a chapter in my book called Hot Dogs with Oprah, and just meeting her, and she gave me a cooking show years ago. I know, I'm trying to, like, how do you do this classy on TV?
Well, you also won a game show, or like a show that, show that she had.
Her search for the next TV star, so I won a cooking show, and just seeing how authentic she was, it inspired in me. So now everything I create, I want to be 100% authentic. Aww. I feel like you can't be truly confident or happy unless you're completely authentic.
In everything in life.
Yeah.
In everything
like
in
eating
life.
With your mouth full. I mean,
like me waiting for you to have a mouthful.
Yeah. Right.
Thank
Cheers.
You so much. I'm going to dive into this guy right
Thank
here.
You for having
hey, everybody,
me.
You'll find this recipe at HallmarkChannel.com. Be sure to pick up a copy of Kristina's new book, Hold On, But Don't Hold Still. And that is available wherever books are sold.